Hey there! Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired Word of God and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today, and we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church. Hey there! Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired Word of God and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate, and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
Good evening, church. Welcome to our 7 p.m. worship experience here at the United Methodist Church of Wilton. I am Pastor Steve, and on behalf of the whole congregation here, I want to welcome you to this time of celebration, this time of praise, this time of learning what God is calling us to do. So tonight, as we pray, and as we sing, and as we celebrate our risen Lord, we'll be looking at worry. From the Sermon on the Mount, when Jesus told his disciples how to live as Christians, as part of our series, The Church in a Polarized World. So at this time, let us bring the light of Christ into our virtual worship service so that we may continue to praise God with all of our hearts, with all of our mind, and with all of our soul.
Join me in the call to worship. In the midst of the world's chaos,
come to this place and find peace.
When your mind is overwhelmed with what you see,
come to this place and find hope.
If your heart is heavy with fear and worry,
come to this place and find strength.
As you long for community in a world that is polarized,
come to this place and find love.
Come, people of God, and in this place, in this moment,
let go of worry as we worship and pray together.
Wonderful.
Wow. Hello, everybody.
Hello, everyone.
Peace be with you.
And also with you.
Our first praise song this morning is perfect for our theme today about worry. It's I Lay My Worries Down. It tells about how we as Christians should be able to lay our worries down and let Christ have them. So join together in singing this. And the good news is that wherever you're at, you can sing as loud as you want. You can dance if you want. You can celebrate God's time with us today.
I will lay my
Of joys and concerns. If you have a joy or concern that I don't get mentioned and you'd like it lifted up and put on the prayer list, I would ask that you email me or send me a text at 319-939-4777. I would also ask that you can look down below in the comment section down below here or in the chat line over here, and you can put your comments and your prayer concerns in there also. This week we want to continue to pray for our church members that are recovering, that are doing physical therapy or just taking time to heal. We want to continue to pray for Phyllis Nouse, who had surgery this past week, Rita Sloan, who is now home from the hospital but is still in physical therapy, Don Hartman and Jim Lincoln, as they continue to do their therapy and to recover from their procedures. We want to continue to keep in our prayers those that are dealing with ongoing treatments. Marcia Hetzler, Carolyn Tharp, Diane Budding, and Rick Steffens, all dealing with the after effects and the side effects of their therapies and their treatments. We want to continue to pray for our farmers, those bringing in the harvest, our policemen and firemen, ambulance drivers, EMTs, those dealing with COVID-19, those dealing with tragedies in our community. Keeping your prayers, those on the front lines, those working in grocery stores and restaurants, those that have to work, yet have to live out there in the midst of a virus that is dangerous. Ask for prayers for our school, which has been doing so well at protecting our children and our community. But as the numbers increase, it will keep getting harder. So keep them in your prayers to help them to maintain their distance, to continue to stay safe. We want to continue to pray for our young men and women in the armed services who are serving to protect, to bring about freedom and justice. Help them to understand that they need to seek God and listen and discern what is right, what is prudent, what is loving. Continue to pray for our missionaries around the world that in this difficult time are dealing with more issues than they're used to. Also, keep your church in your prayers. as we continue to find ways to deal with COVID-19, with increasing numbers in this pandemic, so that we may keep everybody safe, continue to love our neighbors, to protect, and yet to continue to love. So with all of that, let us join together in our unison prayer.
Let us pray.
Lord Jesus Christ, you tell us not to be afraid of what the future holds and not to worry about tomorrow. It is so difficult to heed your words because we worry about many things: our families, our circumstances, our health. Some worries are big and others are small. This day, we come to you with both our big and small worries, knowing that we can lay them at your feet. In a church and world that is polarized, inspire us to hear your call to follow, to trust, and to live in confidence that you are making all things new. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, I ask that you pour out your Holy Spirit upon all of us, gathered around our devices, gathered with family, or gathered alone. Lord, we praise you and thank you for being with us wherever we're at whatever time we've gathered, that you may continue to allow your Spirit to flow over us in these unusual, polarized, difficult times. Lord, today, our hearts are breaking, our minds are soaring, our bodies are worrying. We don't know what tomorrow will bring, and yet you reassure us not to worry. But Lord, we are just mere human, and it comes so naturally. So help us. Pour out your Spirit upon us. Ease our minds, our souls, and our hearts. Help us to hear those reassuring words of yours, to not worry, to love, to trust, to follow. Lord, you've heard our hearts and our minds. Lord, we have family members and church members who are dealing with so many things in their lives: health issues, financial issues, issues of the mind, body, heart, and soul. Lord, sometimes it just overwhelms us thinking about the needs around us. So Lord, help us and direct us to be your hands and feet, to love our neighbor, to love ourselves. Help us to work towards loving our enemy. Lord, pour out your Spirit upon those who are dealing with this COVID-19. Be with those that are searching for treatments and vaccinations and cures. Lord, be with those who are treating and healing. Lord, be with the therapists that are dealing with issues of the mind. Deal with the physical therapists that are dealing with issues of the muscle and bone. Lord, be with our people as they deal with chemotherapy and radiation. Lord, today, as we sit, as we pray, as we contemplate, speak to us. Help us to hear your words of assurance, to hear your words of good news, to help us be assured of where we are going and what we are doing. Lord, come. Sit with us now in a time of silence. Pour out your Spirit upon us. Hold us. Talk to us. Help us to lay our worries at your feet and to be able to walk away from them. Lord, come be with us now in this time of silence. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for spreading yourself out from house to house, device to device, heart to heart, soul to soul. Lord, thank you for helping us to discern, pushing us where we need to be pushed, pulling where we need to be pulled, stopping where we need to stop. Lord, we thank you and praise you with that prayer that you taught your disciple so long ago.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Those who have prayed that prayer, those who have opened up their hearts, their minds, and their souls to allow God to continue to work within your hearts, to work within your minds, to allow you to overcome worry in your life and to live as a free and loving Christian. God has a plan for you. And the good news that Jesus Christ went to that cross for your sins, went to the grave to conquer death, and gave us the proof by rolling away that stone to let us know that we will have eternal life. And so with that in mind, let us sing our next song, which proclaims that when all God's people said, Amen.
You are not alone if you are alone.
Church in a polarized world. As we look at the Sermon on the Mount today, our subject is worry. Something that as humans, as mere mortals, comes so naturally to us. To worry about what we wear, to worry about what we have to eat, to worry about where we're going or what we can do, to worry about our children or worry about our parents, to worry about our neighbors, to worry about our church, to worry about our community. Worry seems to be the easy default. So today, as we think about what it means to be a Christian in a world that is separated and causes us to worry, what Christ is calling us to do and to be. So hear these words.
From the Gospel of Matthew, the Sermon on the Mount, chapter 6, beginning with verse 25. Jesus said, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, 'What will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear?' For it is the Gentiles who strives for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today." The Word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Mike and Kay Heim for that wonderful song, Bridge Over Troubled Waters. For Jesus truly is our bridge over these troubled waters, these waters that keep us worrying. So now let us prepare ourselves for what God has preparing on my heart this week. Let us pray. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit upon me and upon those gathered around their devices, that the words that you have placed upon my heart, my mind, and my soul may find a place in these your people. Lord, help us to continue to grow into our role as disciples in our community. Allow this time to be a one of preparation, a one of learning. So, Lord, we thank you and praise you for today, tomorrow, and the days to come. Amen. Worry. I worry. I'm sure you worry. I'm sure there have been times when, as the saying goes, you were worried sick. When those things that have been upon your heart and mind and soul have kept you from sleeping at night, from kept you from being your best, that have kept you from loving the way that God wants you to love. And that's exactly at the heart of our scripture today. Jesus talking to his disciples on that Sea of Galilee, the shoreline there, with a mountain in front of him and the people stretched out as he was teaching his disciples. I want to remind you that they were in a world that was probably even more polarized than the one that we live in. It was a place where the government ruled with an iron hand, at the point of a sword. If you disobeyed, you were imprisoned, enslaved, or killed. The church was divided between the Pharisees and the Sadducees. The countryside was divided by tribe and by sanctions from Samaritans and Jews and Gentiles, all of them not really wanting to get along. And then along comes Jesus, this itinerant rabbi, walking from town to town, village to village, preaching the good news of God, of love, of acceptance. And here in these chapters of Matthew 5, 6, and 7, we see this sermon where he teaches us ways to live in a polarized world. Because that's what he was doing. He was teaching his disciples how to live, how to be, how to continue to be together as well as standing firm in the face of oppression, in the face of injustice, and the acts of horrible things that were going on around them. They were to be God's hands and feet, to be bringers of mercy and justice. And they did not have time to worry about that. Right before the scripture lesson that we looked at today, that is a portion of this sermon that we won't be specifically title on, but it has a lot to do with what Jesus got to in this part of worry. And it comes right there before it, basically just verse 24, right before what Anne read. It says, "No one can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth." These words were the predecessor to talking about worry, talking about what it meant to live in that era and in the 2,000 years that have hence been. For most of humanity's worries often come down to survival, come down to wealth, come down to whether or not you have enough possessions to be clothed, whether you have enough money to buy food or enough wealth to own land to produce food. And so in the simple terms of that first century Christians, they had to decide whether they were going to wholeheartedly pursue wealth in order to satisfy their human needs so that they didn't worry about physical possessions, or whether they would give themselves over to allowing God to direct them and to help them. And that was the charge given to the disciples. Live for today, for tomorrow brings enough worries of its own. Those times, the disciples needed to live for the moment. Love for the moment. Be generous for the moment. For tomorrow would give them new opportunities to witness, to testify, to be a part of God's kingdom and a new set of challenges. Now, sometimes we look back at that time 2,000 years ago, 200 years ago, 20 years ago, and we think, oh, if we could just go back to those simple times when we didn't have to worry so much. I don't agree. The worries of those times were definitely different than the worries of this time, but I don't think they were any simpler. To live under a dictator, to live under martial law, to live with churches that were arguing theology and doctrine more than caring for their own people. 200 years ago, living in the existence of lack of medical, lack of understanding of human physiology, allowed people to not live a healthy life as long as we do now. 20 years ago, the freedoms and technology that has come in the last 20 years, I'm sure that if we went back, we would be feeling oppressed or lack of knowledge or just hemmed in. We all have our favorite memories of times long ago when we felt like we weren't worrying about stuff. I've heard the stories of those good old days back in school, back in college, back when we used to hang out with my friends, back when we used to do this or to do that, even back in the good old days of church when it seemed like the church building was always full. We've been worrying forever. That's never gone away. Jesus knew that, wanted his disciples to know that, and wants us to know that. And he gives it to us in those beautiful verses about the fact that if the lilies of the field in all their beauty can trust God, if even the plain grass can trust even though it may be gone tomorrow, that the birds of the air with their feathers and their songs, if they can live to the glory of God, then so can we. But it takes work, just like all the other parts of being a disciple. Being a Christian is hard work. Sometimes it is harder during a time like this of isolation and pandemic, a time when we can't gather together like the good old days. But yet, there are new ways of showing God's love, of bringing about God's kingdom. Things that we can set our mind to today so that we can put aside those lesser worries and allow God to continue to work through us as we work on issues of mission and of justice, as we look to right the wrongs of our society, to bring about justice and mercy to those who have had that withheld over all these years. God wants us, needs us, is looking for us to continue to build God's kingdom here on earth. To focus on God's kingdom. And when we do that, much of our worries will just disappear. And the worries that don't, we can rely on one another. We can ask one another. We can share with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Part of being a Christian community is the fact that we can hold each other up. That we can take these burdens in common and share them. Pray about them. It is amazing how in a community, when we share those concerns, somebody might have something that can help us out. And that is what Christian community is about. That is how we get by in a polarized world. We don't let it polarize our community. We pull together in commonality to love and to serve. So this next week, as we take time to shelter, as we take time to be safe, take a moment to think about your neighbors, to think about your church members, to think about those on the prayer list. And is there something that you can do that it might alleviate a little of their worry? Pray for them. Pan of cookies. A gift card to buy some gas as they go off to the hospital. Is there something that we can do as individuals, as a community, as a church, to continue to support God's ministry here in our region? Let us pray. Lord, pour out your Spirit upon us. Help us to turn our worry into work. Help us to turn our work into mission. Help us to turn our mission into testimony. Help us, Lord, to build your kingdom here on earth, that you may work through us, using our hands, our feet, our tongues, to spread your good news and to be examples of love. Lord, I thank you and praise you for all that you are doing in this congregation, in this community. We look forward to testifying to all that is yet to come. Amen.
We come to that time of our worship service to take up our gifts and our tithes, a time where we can give back to God a portion of what God has gifted us. I realize that during this time of pandemic and this time of layoffs and furloughs that not everybody has the capability to give, and that's okay. Take care of yourself, take care of your family. There are plenty of people taking care of the church during this time for us to get through. For those of you that would like to contribute to the mission and ministry of our church, there are several ways that you can do that. You can write a check, mail it to the church at Post Office Box 57, Wilton, Iowa, 52778, or you can go to our website, www.umcofwilton.org, click on the button for online giving. We have partnered with Vanco to make it safe and secure for you to give online. At this time, I want to thank you for all the support that you have given our church. If any of you are in need of assistance, please give me a call. I have funds for helping out members of the church. As these gifts come from all of us, let us join together to dedicate these to God's ministry and mission. Let us pray.
O God, you call us to be your light in the darkness, your voice in the wilderness, and your hope for the hopeless. Give us strength and courage to proclaim more of you and less of us. May these gifts be used to break down hatred and build up love. Amen.
Announcement time. Time for us to look at what is going on in our church and what it is that you can be involved in during this time of pandemic, during this time of isolation. Right now, I want to let you know that the UMW will be meeting this Thursday, November 29th at 1:30 at Kay Henning's house in her garage. You need to bring your own mask and bring a lawn chair so that you can enjoy a time of fellowship as Audrey Luthy gives the program on offering of thanks. Missions is going to continue to be collecting kits for the in-gathering. Connie had told me that all of the health kits have been turned in and are ready to go. All we're now looking for is anybody that might still have one of the other kits. If you want to get those turned in, they need to come in this week to the tubs at the north side of the church. Next Sunday, we'll be dedicating those and getting them ready to be sent to the in-gathering the following week. So get those ready. The mission team is also looking to find out who is interested in going to a mission trip. Next August, the 1st through the 6th, they are collecting names of those that might be interested. So if that sounds like something you might be interested in doing, and hopefully the pandemic is over, just give Jill Akers a call, a text message, or an email, and let her know that you are interested in going. If you can't get a hold of Jill, you can call the church office and just leave your name and a number and the fact that you would like to go on that mission trip on the answer machine, and we'll get you put on the list. This next week, because the pandemic has reached a high of over 12% positivity, there is absolutely nothing going on at the church. We will be letting you know next Friday, like we did this week, about what the standard and status is for worship on November 1st. For further updates, keep watching our Facebook page. Listen to the announcements that come from our One Call Now phone call. And of course, they'll all be updated on our weekly email blast that comes out on Saturday.
As we go out into this polarized world, hear the good news. We are blessed in the midst of God's love. We are blessed in what we feel, see, and do. We are blessed even in the times we find it hard to see the blessing. Even then, we can know ourselves as children of God. Especially then, we can trust that God is present in our lives. God's love was shown and given by the one who came to save us. Blessed are you in the name of Christ. And all God's people said, Amen.
This time together today, as we've worshiped and as we've prayed and as we've studied, our final song is Trust and Obey. Allowing Christ to work within us to be disciples, to do and to go without worry, to bring about God's kingdom here on earth. So let us sing as we prepare to go out into our world.
With the Lord in the light of His Word, what a glory He sheds on our way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey. For there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a shadow can rise, not a cloud in skies, but His smile quickly drives it away. Not a doubt nor a fear, not a sigh nor a tear can abide while we trust and obey. Oh, trust and obey, for there's no other Jesus, but to trust and obey. aside in the way. What he says we will do, where he sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Oh, trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. And 'tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him.